All right, we're going to get started. Adequate notice of this March 27th, 2023, regular monthly meeting of the Cranford Board of Education was provided on December 15th, 2022, by a meeting notice posted in the boardroom, Lincoln School, and communicated to the Star Ledger, Westfield Leader, and the Office of the Township Clerk, and all board members. Please rise for the flag salute.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mrs. Carbone.
Here.
Mr. Darling.
Here.
Mr. Dreyer.
Here.
Mr. Hulse.
Here.
Mr. Lynch.
Here.
Mrs. Mallon.
Here.
Mrs. Shaw.
Here.
Mrs. Soltis.
Here.
Mr. Petchap.
Here.
We have a quorum.
Thank you. Dr. Rubin, so right to you.
Great. Thank you very much, Mr. Petchow. Good evening, everyone. Nice to see all of you here. We will start off, as we traditionally do, with one of our favorite parts, and that is listening to our board liaisons. Gianna, we're going to start off with you, and you can tell us what's happening over at the... Actually, I'm going out of order, aren't I? Hold on here. We don't want to mess with tradition here. We're actually going to start over at our middle schools. So we'll head over to OAS, and we've got Thomas Villarreal and Addison Freeman, if you could give us reports over at OAS.
So, good evening, Board of Ed members. As we continue with spring, even more exciting activities are beginning and ending at OAS. Starting with Student Council, as the student Council will be hosting a small business fair during April. The small business fair will allow OAS students to sell their own products to students as well as teachers. Moving on, our March bake sale was a success, making not $200 but over $250. However, our March Madness basketball contest was canceled due to inclement weather. We hope to reschedule for the first week in April.
Around OAS, we've had P2E and Japanese classes have field trips, and they were both well-liked and enjoyed. And addition to this, the elementary had a school social, and it was packed with kids, and it was very well-liked, just like the field trips. And we also recently had our Beauty and the Beast play. It was over St. Patrick's Day weekend, and on Sunday, we even had the auditorium sell out, and I congratulate everyone who's in that play because it was really good. And teachers and students all enjoyed it. And finally, we had baseball and softball teams. They were picked after days of tryouts, and games will start soon. And a lot of people who tried out made it, but they're also filling some spots over at Hillside. Thank you.
Great job. A lot of great and exciting activities. Thank you so much. When is that small business event?
The small business sale is an event that the Student Council will be hosting. It basically, if you're a student and you made your own product, you can sell it there in the cafeteria, and other students can buy it for your price, and so can teachers.
Excellent, great. I'm heading over there. I'm going to be there. Excellent, thank you.
That's very good.
All right, we're going to head over to Hillside. Alex Kessler, are you solo today?
Yeah.
All right, you can handle it. I know you can.
Thank you, first of all. My printer wasn't working, so I'll be reading this off my phone. So, hello, Board of Education. The students at HAS performed their play Mary Poppins on Friday and over the weekend. The show was great thanks to the hard work all the actors, stage crew, and teachers involved. The Student Council has been preparing for a school clothing drive that is coming up this spring. We're going to pack clothes and send it to places that donate the clothes. The middle school dance is set for the end of April. Students will vote on the themes between tropical, pajama, and neon. Elementary school students recently had an assembly called Bullies to Buddies. This assembly, the students learned about building strategies to become resilient students. With the year almost over, the high school students came to talk with the eighth graders about what to expect next year in high school and the changes from middle school to high school. One of the biggest, most anticipated events coming up next Wednesday is the STAT versus HAS versus 8th grade volleyball game. We've been practicing all year, and hopefully we can become the first class to beat the teachers. Thank you.
Great job, Alex. Thank you very much for sharing that update. And thank you to both of our advisors in the back there. Thank you very much. And then now, last but not least, oh my goodness, we're going to go over to the high school. And Gianna, why don't you give us an update?
Thank you so much, Dr. Rubin. Last Friday, our senior class defeated the faculty in the senior vs. faculty basketball game. It was 88-89. It was definitely a nail biter. And most of the teachers that were walking in, they were, you know, stumbling to get up those steps. I think we we definitely.
Thankfully,
had
this isn't
fun.
Being recorded, so we're good. Yeah, keep going.
But it was great. We had so much participation from the senior class and so much support in the stands. It was wonderful. Track and tennis practice is underway, boys tennis. And I was talking to my friend who's on the track team, and she said something that just really stuck out to me. She said that she loves being in track because it's social, mental, and physical exercise. Like, she's getting that physical exercise, but she's also getting the social aspect of it, meeting new people, but it's also helping her mentality, pushing her to be better. And that's, I think, what CHS is really about. It's pushing students to be better mentally, physically, and socially. And with that, I'd like to bring it over to our performing arts department. The spring musical was amazing. It was Into the Woods, and our students did such an amazing job. The performances were spectacular, and the stage crew did such a wonderful job working on the sets every single day after school for hours on end, so it was really wonderful to see the show come together full circle. This Friday is the much-anticipated senior fashion show. This year's theme is disco, and we are so excited for you all to come and see our performances. We've worked so hard on them, so I hope you all come. And immediately following the fashion show is the senior lock-in. It'll take place from 10 p.m. to 1 a.m. We're going to bring in snacks and drinks, and it'll just be sort of this big party. There's going to be games there, so it'll be super fun. And I can't really talk about these two events without thanking our custodial staff. They've done an amazing job cleaning up after our practices at the school and providing us with just such a healthy and clean environment to work in, a safe environment too. So with that, I'd like to thank our custodians and our teachers and turn it back to Dr. Rubin. Thank you so much.
Great. Thank you. And let's give all of our liaisons one more round of applause. They make it look so easy. Great, thank you. Fabulous to hear about all the different events that are happening at all the schools. We're going to go a little bit out of order, and so we're going to pause for a second to move one of the resolutions.
Before I go into that, I just want to let you know, Alex, that your advisor that's here doesn't think you have a shot at that volleyball game, just so you know. He was shaking his head vehemently that you have no shot.
But and stretching.
At least you know once you get to the high school, there's a shot. But maybe you could be a first one. But, John, I do like the fact that you led with that. That was very good. Very good. So we are going to go a little out of order. Brett, will you please move resolution number 15? And then we will vote on it. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, I'd like to move resolution number 15, appointments.
Take a vote.
Yes. Mrs. Carbone.
Yes.
Mr. Darling.
Yes.
Mr. Dreyer.
Yes.
Mr. Hulse.
Yes.
Mr. Lynch.
Yes.
Mrs. Mallon.
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw.
Yes.
Mrs. Soltis.
Yes.
Mr. Petchow.
Yes.
Motion carried.
Thank you. Dr. Rubin, back to you.
Great. Thank you so much. So what the board just voted on in part was to approve Thomas Manzo as the new Cranford High School assistant principal. And shortly after the meeting, we'll have the following press release go out. And in a moment, I'm going to introduce Thomas Manzo to the community. So the Cranford Board of Education is pleased to announce Thomas Manzo as the new assistant principal of Cranford High School. Mr. Manzo was selected after an extensive search process, which included multiple interviews with the selection committee, reviews of work samples, and a very thorough reference check. Mr. Manzo graduated early from Irwin University and earned his bachelor's degree in history and education with magna cum laude honors, and earned a master's degree in educational leadership at Montclair State University with summa cum laude honors. After graduating, he found part-time positions at West Essex and Glen Rock High School, which led him to his long-term position at Lodi High School, where he's been for the last 9 years. There, he began his career as a history teacher and then served in numerous roles, including as the INRS 504 case manager, student council advisor, and also the head spring and winter track field coach. Mr. Manzo enjoys crafting lesson plans, collaborating with the department, organizing events for his track teams, and challenging students to be the best they can be. In 2018, Thomas Manzo became the Lodi High School Department Supervisor of Social Studies and Spanish, and subsequently also supervised the business department. Through collaborative efforts, he strived to offer additional opportunities for the educational community, including offering more advanced placement courses, coordinating with the county college to offer dual enrollment courses, and updating the school curriculum to promote diversity, equity, and inclusion. Thomas Manzo lives in East Hanover with his wife, Catherine, who is also here with us today. Thank you. And their 15-month-old daughter, Claire. They're also expecting their second daughter this summer. And we are incredibly excited to welcome Mr. Manzo to our community and our family. I give you Tom Manzo.
Hi, everyone. Just wanted to say thank you. Speaking with you earlier, it's excellent that we have, you know, the same goals in mind, and I'm just very excited for this opportunity.
Fantastic. Thank you. Mr. Canigallo could not be here this evening, but he wanted to extend his congratulations and how excited he is for you to join his team. So, again, thank you very much. Looking forward to all the things that you're going to accomplish here. So a few other items. You know, the district works very hard at social-emotional initiatives. And so the Social-Emotional Learning Alliance for New Jersey actually just recognized Cranford High School. You know, they've got a program where if you do different activities, you know, you earn badges. And as you can imagine, Cranford, or as you've seen, Cranford does a lot of different initiatives. And so we were actually in the number three spot for the amount of activities that we achieved. I heard that there were a few other items we could have put on the list to get in that number one. So number one, you know, look out next year. We're coming for you. So I just want to say thank you to Lisa Burfeind, our director of school counseling, Gail Colucci, our coordinator of culture and climate, all of our school-based culture and climate committees, our school counselors, social workers, all of our mental health professionals, and then also they work very closely with the principals and our staff members and teachers. It all happens in the classroom. There's just a lot of people working together in order to make these things a reality. So we appreciate the support of the board and all the folks in our faculty that were able to make those things possible. I also want to give an update. We had our strategic planning information session last week. As you know, we're starting our new five-year strategic planning initiative. We sent out some correspondence to the community to talk about that initiative. There'll be other opportunities for people to get involved. In fact, on Friday, when I sent out the last correspondence, we also invited folks to be a part of taking a survey to provide feedback into the process. And so parents should have already seen, parents and guardians should have seen the newsletters coming out from the respective schools so that parents and guardians can start filling out those surveys. We also create a survey for non-parent guardian community members. And we've got arrangements for faculty to do a survey as well. And then when we get back from our break, the students will sit for the surveys in the school. So we certainly want to get maximum participation. And we know that it's important to get the perspective through all the different lenses will help us on our road forward. I know I've said it before, but just those folks who are, you know, sort of a snapshot on what strategic planning is, it's a candid, honest look at where we are now. It's a view of where we want to be in 5 years, and then figuring out what is it we need to do in order to bridge the gap from our current state to what our vision is in the future. So we really hope that you participate and lend your voice to the initiative. I also wanted to, I know this is the last board meeting before our upcoming break. I certainly wanted to wish happy holidays to those who are observing the holidays during that time, while also wishing everyone a happy, healthy, and safe break. I know I mentioned this at our last board meeting, but it wasn't televised, so I thought it would be better to repeat it at this one. I've gotten a lot of questions as I walk through the schools about, hey, Dr. Rubin, what are you doing with those emergency days that we have not used yet? I know we all refer to them as snow days, but technically they're emergency days. And so, as been the custom, we give back those days if we don't use them. I know I got some emails after the last board meeting. How could you possibly put a jinx on this? But so far, the weather has been pretty good. I'm hopeful that we're out of the woods. I can't believe I said that out loud. But if we are in a place to give back those days, we will provide a specific update, a little bit after we come back from the break. But what we do is target the days similar to what we did last year. Take a look at Memorial Day, a couple of days there. Maybe it's that Friday and Tuesday because we've got the Monday off already. We have to look at when the testing schedules are to create the least, negative impact. And then also probably that Monday before the primary day that we're off on that Tuesday. So that sort of wraps around and gives a four-day weekend after the five-day weekend. So again, hope to be in that position where we could provide that update. The reason I make the distinction between snow days and emergency days is because you've got things that happen later in the year, like water main breaks and those sorts of things. So you really hold on to those days as long as you can to make sure to maximize the chances that we're not going to leave ourselves short, because I can imagine the last thing people would want is us giving those days and then having to come back a day. That's not very, giving back the days is very popular. Adding a day onto the calendar, I can tell you, less popular. So more on that in the future. And again, happy holidays to all. That's my report.
Thank you, Dr. Rubin. Does anybody have any questions for Dr. Rubin before we move on? All right, Bob, throw it to you.
No report. Thank you.
You're the best. All right. Thank you, Bob. Does anybody have any communications they would like to share? Please, Patrick.
Thanks, Kurt. I just want to make a plug for the Cranford High School Booster Club Wiffle Ball Tournament. So each year, the Booster Club, it's a large fundraising event for the High School Booster Club. They're Wiffle Ball Tournament this year is on May 7th at 11 a.m. at Orange Avenue School. Each team fields 3 to 5 players. It's $150 a team. For more information, you can visit the Booster Club Facebook page for the registration information if you're interested. So each year, the Board of Ed puts together at least one team. With each year, we hope to do a little bit better, but we'll see how it goes. But it's a lot of fun. So thanks, Kurt.
Look at me.
Bob's already warming up.
That's it.
He's getting ready now. He's already warming up.
Some of us have been practicing in the office.
Yeah, he's in spring training. He's ready to go. Thank you, Patrick. Anybody else? Okay. I just have one communication. It was spoken about a couple times already tonight with our liaisons, but I had the opportunity and the privilege to go see Mary Poppins over the weekend. And, every time you go to any of the shows, it just really emphasizes again how wonderful the arts programs are in our schools and, how talented the kids are in this district, because at the middle school level, they're incredible, and then they just, they get to the point of being professional at the high school. So it's just always amazing. And I just wanted to give a shout out to Orange Avenue, Hillside Avenue, and the high school for the amazing programs they put on. And again, as somebody who has a tremendous fear of standing up on a stage in front of people, I cannot believe the things that these young men and women do. They're truly impressive and amazing. And I just can't say enough about it. So thank you for letting me share that. All right. We are going to move on. We are up to our first audience participation. If anybody would like to come up to the mic and make any statements or questions, just state your name and address and talk away.
Okay, my name is Stephanie Levine Ashenhoff. I'm at 193 Arbor Street. I just want to thank you for this opportunity to discuss the third annual Cranford Film Festival and Arts Day. April 22nd is set to be an exciting day in Cranford for the arts. As you can see from the flyer in front of you, it is the live in-theater day for the film festival, and it's also Arts Day. Arts Day is planned in conjunction with Downtown Cranford and is our co-event that aims to raise awareness of the arts. It submerses the downtown in some incredible entertainment, and it is all free. We have several CHS ensembles performing, such as Noteworthy Acting and Jazz Band. Fine arts will be showcased at the Artist Framer. There will be projects and classes, and it all ends with a jazz jam for everyone to join at 4 p.m. at the clock. When Arts Day ends, the Cranford Film Festival begins. As you may know, the Cranford Film Festival is one of the most significant fundraising events for our organization, Cranford School's Friends of Performing Arts. The festival, along with money raised through membership in our organization, allowed us to donate over $17,000 to improve the lighting in the high school auditorium. Our film festival is an exciting event that allows people to come together and enjoy a shared cultural experience while promoting and raising money for the arts. Additionally, our film festival provides educational opportunities for our students to speak with and learn from local filmmakers. Who knows, maybe it will inspire the next Steven Spielberg, Spike Lee, or Sofia Coppola. This year, we have films from a variety of themes, from coping with loss, cancer, to funny, lighthearted takes on navigating relationships and aging relatives. There's truly something for everyone. One film even features Cranford's own Rustic Mill Diner. There are several local films that will be showcased in the festival, and this is a year of record-breaking number of student films that will be screened at the Cranford Theater. Speaking of records, we are set to break a few. We've raised more money in sponsorships this year compared to previous years, so we would like to formally thank our sponsors on TV for their generosity. Three of those sponsors are sitting right here in this room, and we'd like to thank you formally. Additionally, we've raised the most money from submissions this year, and our ticket sales are up over 400% compared to last year. So hurry and get your tickets before we sell out.
Thank you. Anyone else? Okay, seeing none, we're going to move on.
Can I just...
I'm sorry, please.
No, not at all. I just want to thank you. Obviously, a very exciting event, as it has been for the past couple of years. And just want to thank the Friends of Performing Arts. I can't remember the last board meeting where we didn't thank the Friends of Performing Arts for something that they have just recently done, whether it's donated their time, money, resources, whatever it is. You've been so generous with your support, and please know just how appreciative we are. So thank you.
Thank you, Dr. I appreciate you saying that, and thank you. Okay. All right. We're going to move on to old and new business and committee reports. Lisa, did you have one? Please.
So as the board knows, the co-curricular committee met on March 14th. I sent out a report, so everybody should have received that. So just some highlights. We've heard a lot of successes regarding winter sports and our arts programs. We've heard them highlighted through Dr. Rubin and also through some of our board members and Gianna. One of the things that came out of our meeting, which I think was really exciting to hear, is that our staff has said that there's a lot of like pre-COVID spirit coming out of our schools, which is really nice to hear. So our clubs, our sports, our art events are all kind of back to, you know, full activity and engagement and so forth, and that's really nice. I just wanted to highlight two new clubs that are at the high school, Medical Career Club and the Psychology Club, so that's exciting to hear. And I was going to highlight the Arts Day and Film Festival, but Ms. Levine did such a great job that I don't need to do that. So this is definitely, if you haven't gone out to be a part of this day, it's an awesome day out in Cranford. I mean, Cranford does a great job of so many things. But this is a great day, and so many of our students are part of this. And there's a lot of things to actually be engaged with, you know, when you bring your own children or just as an adult. Because Chris from TV 35 even had me drumming on a drum line, unbeknownst to me. But it's a fun day out, and it's great to see our students out and about, and then obviously being part of the film festival. So it's something that definitely you should be out there and supporting. So that's it.
Thank you, Lisa. Anybody have any questions for Lisa before we move on? Okay. And Patrick, you said you had a...
Just want to share with the the board that the personnel committee met this evening prior to tonight's board meeting. Two items to share from that discussion. The committee reviewed tenure and non-tenure staff, and we also discussed ways to enhance programming for students with mental health concerns. Thank you, Kurt.
Thank you, Patrick. Anybody have any questions for Patrick? Okay, does anybody else have any committee reports? All good? All right, we will move on. All right, we are up to formal resolutions. Terry, will you please move resolutions 1 through 10? Yes. Oh, I missed the minutes, right? I just went right past them. Wow. I guess I didn't want to move them. Just wait a minute? I got you. That's a good pun. Patrick, why don't you move the minutes since I missed them?
Sure. I'd like to make a motion, consideration of the minutes of previous meetings, February 13th, 2023, open work session meeting, 7:30 p.m., February 27th, 2023, regular monthly meeting, 7:30 p.m., and February 27th, 2023, executive session, 8:46 p.m.
Second.
Besides me, does anybody have any questions about the minutes? All good? All right.
Mrs. Carbone.
Yes.
Mr. Darling.
Yes.
Mr. Dreyer.
Yes.
Mr. Hulse.
Yes.
Mr. Lynch.
Yes.
Mrs. Mallon.
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw.
Yes.
Mrs. Soltis.
Yes.
Mr. Petchow.
Yes.
Motion carried.
Thank you, Bob. All right, now we are going to move to formal resolution. Sorry about that, Terry. Can you still move 1 for 10 for me, please?
I'd be happy to.
I appreciate it.
I'd like to move resolution 1, business items. Resolution 2, approved revised budget statement 2022-2023. Resolution 3, Board Secretary's monthly certification, budgetary line item status. Resolution 4, acceptance of FY 2023 funding for capital maintenance needs. Resolution 5, 2023 climate awareness grant application. Resolution 6, approval of student information, system maintenance and support contract. Resolution 7, approval of travel expenditures. Resolution 8, field trip destination approval. Resolution 9, HIB decisions, and Resolution 10, out of district placement of a special education student.
Second. Yeah, just real quick, resolution, just for a little background, resolution 4, State of New Jersey for the second year in a row gave money to school districts. They call it a capital maintenance needs, but it's really geared towards HVAC, heating, ventilation, repairs in your schools. So last year we received a similar amount. This year, again, thank you to the state for doing that. Some of the money we've already spent. It was the final phase of the high school univentilator repair project that we had in our budget for the last few years. So we'll be able to get that those funds reimbursed. And we have a couple issues that we need to complete with Lincoln School is one of them, and Walnut Avenue School needs some work done on it. So those funds will go in a good area. Any funds go in any, they're always a good area. But it's a need that we have, and it's just accepting the funds and spending it on maintenance. So we had it last year too, so it's a good thing.
Thank you, Bob, I appreciate you explaining
any
that.
Any questions on that? It's not really an application. I'll submit what schools were doing the work and what work we're doing or what work's been done. And it's pretty painless, and they reimburse us, so it's a good thing.
Thank you. Do we have any other questions on 1 through 10?
Number 5, could we're always being asked about getting grants and things like that. Could that just be explained a little bit more?
Sure, and this one does have to do with the New Jersey Learning Standards. Do you want to share about the climate grant?
Yes, well, this one...
Hang on one sec. Could you just put your mic down?
Yeah.
Oh. Well, are we volleying it over here?
Yeah, I was going to ask Bob to explain the grant itself, because it was not a, I think it was a given to everyone, correct, Bob?
Yeah, it was an entitlement grant. Again, entitlement grants are not competitive grants, where the state gives you the amount that you're eligible for, and you still have to apply for them to get them. Brian could touch on the curriculum piece of that, because it's part of the standards. But we were notified that we have $6,660 eligible for the climate awareness program, and it was put together to provide professional development and supplies in that area, and has to be spent between April and June. So it was kind of a rush job, but it's a good thing, good program. So we've submitted it already, to be honest, to do that, because the time was of the essence. but it is tied to the curriculum and what teachers are going to get involved in with climate awareness that's required by the state.
Yeah, so one of the new things that the state had in their mandates from 2 years ago was including student instruction in climate change awareness K-12. And so part of what we're using this grant money for is to send representative teachers from all of our buildings to be trained in various models of instruction around that. And that I think that took up the majority of the money, and then use the rest of that money for the materials they'll need to start infusing that. So basically it's a turnkey professional development to make sure that our teachers have the knowledge and strategy needed to implement those new standards going forward.
Thank you. I appreciate that, and it's important that we share. I think we share that because people are always asking about grants, so thank you.
We've been very fortunate over the past few years.
Any other questions on 1 through 10?
Okay. Mrs. Carbone?
Yes.
Mr. Darling?
Yes.
Mr. Dreyer?
Abstain 9, yes, the other ones.
Mr. Hulse?
Yes.
Mr. Lynch?
Yes.
Mrs. Mallon?
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw?
Yes.
Mrs. Soltis?
Yes.
Mr. Petchow?
Yes.
Motion carried.
Thank you. Brett, will you please move resolutions 11 through 20, just skipping 15 because we did it already.
Yes, I'd like to move resolution 11, approval of substitutes and home instructors. Resolution 12, retirements. Resolution 13, resignation. Resolution 14, leave of absence. Resolution 16, contract revisions. Resolution 17, staff reassignment. Resolution 18, additional assignment club. Resolution 19, miscellaneous additional assignment lunchroom. And resolution 20, miscellaneous additional assignment nursing.
Second. Anybody have any questions on 11 through 20?
Mr. Petcher, I just want to recognize, I just want to recognize our folks on our retirees on resolution 12. And again, I love that we've got the years of service here, 26 and 25.7 years of service. Not surprising here in Cranford. It's really wonderful to see. We certainly congratulate them on their retirement, wish them well. We'll be celebrating them at an upcoming board meeting, but do want to thank them here.
Thank you, Dr. Rubin. Anybody else? Okay.
Mrs. Carbone?
Yes.
Mr. Darling?
Yes.
Mr. Dreyer?
Yes.
Mr. Hulse?
Yes.
Mr. Lynch?
Yes.
Mrs. Mallon?
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw?
Yes.
Mrs. Soltis?
Yes.
Mr. Petchow?
Yes.
Motion carried.
Thank you, Bob. Okay, that is it for our formal resolutions. We are up to our second audience participation. If anybody would like to come up, ask any questions, or make any statements. Okay. Seeing none, we are going to need a executive session. Patrick, will you please move us into executive session for student matters?
Oh, I'm sorry. I move that the Board of Education recess to an executive session for consideration of issues dealing with student matters. Action may be taken on these items when the board later returns to public session. Minutes of the executive session may be released to the public after the reasons for non-disclosure no longer exist.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All right. We'll just take a couple minute recess and come back in for executive session. Thank you, everyone.
Have a great evening.
Have a great night.